this is the second video in the Practicum instructional video series. After watching this video, you will understand the prerequisites that need to be met before starting the practicum experience and the practicum requirements. Before you're eligible to begin your practicum, you need to have successfully completed the required Public Health Foundations course, 3 additional core required public health classes, and a total of at least 18 credits. These prerequisites need to be satisfied prior to beginning your practicum. Successful completion of a core required course means that you received a grade of B- or better. Generally, for full-time students who are on the 2-year track, the earliest you would be eligible to begin your practicum is in the summer in between the 2 academic years, but it can also be completed in a fall or spring term. Students who previously completed the certificate program through the Colorado School of Public Health may be eligible for the practicum in their first or second semester of the MPH program. During the practicum, you should work a minimum of 120 hours. We want to stress that this is the minimum requirement and should not be seen as a cap. Most students will go beyond the 120 hours, and we really want you to focus on the experience and not simply obtaining your 120 hours. You will submit a learning plan and placement agreement as part of your pre-practicum documentation, and this will outline specific activities or tasks that you will complete. The person who supervises you during your practicum is who we refer to as the practicum preceptor. All pre-practicum documentation needs to be submitted in the pre-practicum Canvas site and approved by your assigned practicum advisor prior to beginning any hours toward your practicum. You are also not able to register for the practicum course until all pre-practicum documents are reviewed and approved. Once your practicum is approved, you will be emailed a permission code to register for the practicum, which is PBHC6860 for students completing the practicum through the CSU campus. Each practicum for every student will look different. There may be multiple students working for the same organization, but one may be conducting data analysis, for example, while another is working on an educational outreach program. The practicum is meant to be tailored to your interests, the competencies that you want to address, and the skills that you want to gain. Now that you know what the requirements are for being eligible for the practicum and what the minimum requirements are for the practicum, please feel free to watch the other videos. And as always, please get in touch with your assigned practicum advisor if you have any questions.